So far, I've centered the servos, assembled the servo horns, and started assembling the frame. Okay. The shock mounts, tanks, and the rear suspension brackets, and all the cross members. Just assemble one side, and then attach the other frame rail, tighten everything down, you're good to go. Next, we're going to assemble the shift rods and the steering linkage. Basically, going to make sure take the rod ends and screw them on to the rods. And you're going to pay attention to the lengths that are mentioned in the manual. You might want to measure them either with a ruler or a caliper, just to make sure you get them the right length. These are not turnbuckles, they're threaded the same direction on both sides. So when you do, if you do get the length wrong, you're going to have to disconnect them to adjust them later on. Just get them as close as possible now and you shouldn't have too much adjustment later. Next, it's time to assemble the shocks or the dampers. I'm going to take the bodies, take the shock body. First, you got to remove the one cap, set that aside. Take your shock shafts, apply a small amount of grease on the shaft so that it's going to function free, move freely. You got your spacer, goes over the screw. Now the shock shaft screw goes through. And then you're going to put the rod ends on the shaft. You can tighten it down. Next, springs. These are just basically small little pen springs. Just go right into the shock body and your cap. Screws right on. And there you go, fully assembled, ready to go. You gotta do this 6 times. Onto the front suspension. First, we're going to hang the shackles for the front leaf springs. They're gonna mount right here. Grab your 3x18 step screw, apply some grease to the screw or to the shaft. You've got one half of the shackle. You've got the bushing or spacer that goes between. The other half. And then you've got one more spacer before going ahead. Attach it to the frame. Make sure it's secured. Don't over tighten it. You don't want to strip the threads in the aluminum frame. But, okay, and then you should still be free to move. Next, the front shocks, take one shock, 3x15 screw, and one of the shock bushings comes with the kit. And through that top hole on that shock mount, you've got serrated lock nuts that go on the back side. Go ahead and tighten that down. And then you've got to go ahead and go do that on the other side also. Are you going to assemble the front axle and leaf springs? You got two U-bolts per spring. U-bolts goes around the spring. Line it up on the axle with your spring seats, aluminum spring seats. Use your serrated lock nuts for these. Get it started. Now you can set the second spring in place. More serrated nuts. Tighten those down nice. Okay. Then you've also got your damper stays. Okay, these go right onto the axle. Right, mounted right there around the spring. 3x6mm machine screw. Okay, go ahead and assemble the other side. Oh, now we got the steering knuckles assembled. Remember, left and right are different part numbers. Keep an eye on which one you're working on. Don't mix those up. Got your ball ends here. Go in. 3mm nuts. Go right into the socket on the part there, on the knuckle. Thread that on there nice and tight. On this side you've got one more. Let's do the top. Same thing, there's a socket on the bottom where the nut will go. This is why it's important to keep these separate. They're different also because this one right here, you only use one ball stud. Again, same thing, assemble it up, tighten it up, and you're good to go. Now we get to attach the axle to the truck. I'm going to start at the front. You've got 3x14 step screws. You can use 6 of those and 6 lock nuts. Stick it through the front mount there, through the leaf spring. Okay. Your lock nut on the back side. Okay. Go to the other side of the front of the frame. Do the spring. Do the eye of the spring. And back out through the bracket. Another screw or another nut. Okay, now we can move on to the back, the rear spring mount on the shackle there. Again, through one side of the shackle, through the eye of the spring, and through that back shackle. Lock nut. And same thing on the other side. Okay, next, you're going to attach the dampers to the damper stay on the axle. Make sure you've got your the ends on the damper, you know, lined up. Into the bracket. And a screw, another step screw. And a lock nut. Do the same thing on the other shock. And tighten them all up. I'm going to attach the shift linkage to the shifter servo. Ball cup. It's a ball stud there. Wanna under the axle there, and it should just snap onto the onto there, onto the ball stud. Now, sometimes you're gonna want to use a pair of pliers to snap that on there, because it may be tight, but this one went on nice and smooth. Now, you see this here, front of the truck is coming along, you've got functional leaf spring suspension on this truck. Okay, I'm going to attach the steering knuckles to the axle now. Take your steering knuckle. This is the one that has both ball studs. This is going to go on the what's going to be the left side of the truck. Take your axle shaft. Make sure the hole lines up. Okay. Take the kingpin. Goes up through the axle, through the knuckle, and that steering shaft. Okay. Next, the kingpin is held in with these little E-clips. And you can push them in with your fingernail. Other times a pair of pliers or a small screwdriver works. Okay. Move on to the next side. Same thing. Now the steering links, the shorter link goes from the servo to the front of the knuckle. Again, these may need to be, they may pop on nice and easy. You may want a pair of pliers to help squeeze that on. Pop it right on, boom. Next, the longer link connects the two knuckles together. Snap that onto the ball studs. Front end is complete for now. I'm going to move on to the back suspension.